Good day everyone, my name is Alex and welcome to another TV box review. Yet another box with Amlogic S905x, and it does seem that they will never ever end. So this one is called the TX3 Pro. Inside we have 1GB of RAM and 8GB of internal storage and running Android 6.0. This is one of the cheapest boxes with Amlogic S905x, and of course I left some links in the video's description if you wanna check it out. Next, I want to show you what comes in the box with this little box, and then I'm going to show you how the box performs. Let's begin. The TX3 Pro comes in this box right here. Not that much information onto the box, just the model name right here onto the back. And on this side, some information that we see on most of these TV boxes. Inside the box, we find the remote control, the same remote control that we see on many of these TV boxes, and this remote control takes two AAA batteries. I do recommend using a wireless keyboard and mouse for a better experience. We also find the HDMI cable, a very generic manual, not that much information in it, and the same power adapter that we see on most of these TV boxes. Now the box itself, it is made out of plastic entirely and it does feel a bit cheap. On the front we have the IR receiver and also a blue LED that stays on whenever the box is on. Onto the right hand side we have a slot for a TF card and two USB ports. On the back of the box we have the AV output, the SPDIF, the network adapter port, HDMI and where the power adapter goes. The back of the box is also made out of plastic and on the corners here we just have some rubberized legs. For the duration of this video, I'll be using this wireless keyboard and mouse, and I left a link in the top right corner or the video's description if you wanna check it out. As soon as we turn the box on, we get the S905X logo, and this is their boot up animation. After a few seconds, the box turns on, and this is the launcher that we get. It looks just like the launcher that we've seen on most of these TV boxes. First thing I've noticed is the fact that we don't have the navigation bar at the bottom of the screen, and there is no way of actually getting that bar, not even from the settings. So I'm gonna start by going to apps so I can show you what apps come pre-installed. So we do get the Play Store, Showbox, YouTube, Skype and Twitter. So not that many apps pre-installed, and also Kodi 16.1 that's sitting right here. Next, let's go to the settings app. So the settings app looks just like the settings app that you've seen on most of these TV boxes. At network, we're just gonna see the networks available. At display here, we can select whatever screen resolution we want. Of course, this will be different depending on what TV you have. And at sounds here, you can just select the digital sounds. And again, depending on your setup, you can choose a different one. But apps here we can check out and see what version of Kodi comes pre-installed. So let's just go to Kodi here. So Kodi. And it's version 16.1. Next at storage and reset, we'll check that from more settings. So I was able to install an SD card onto the box and it became internal storage and you can see it right here. So any app that I'm gonna install now are gonna be installed onto the SD card, and that gives us a lot of space to install apps. So that's about it for storage. Let's go to languages and input. I'm gonna show you what languages are available onto this TV box. So I'm just gonna scroll to them. Hopefully you see the one that you're interested in. So quite a few languages available. And that's about it for the languages. At about media box here we can see the Android version. It's Android version 6.01 and this is the model number of the box, so TX3 Pro. And I'm back to the settings app here, and the only thing that we see different, well, this is kind of normal for the TV boxes Android 6, we can select what the power button should do when pressed. And that's about it for the settings app. This box does not have Bluetooth. So now let's get back onto the main launcher. So this main launcher can be changed. You can install any other launcher that you wish. So if you want to install Nova launcher, you can easily do so. However, one thing that I have noticed, so I'm gonna open the Play Store here. Just like the TX5 Pro, nothing works from the Play Store. So you can search for games, for example. If you search for Asphalt 8, nothing will show up. So Asphalt 8 is not gonna show up. If you search for GTA, for example, nothing will also show up. So nothing for GTA either. Real Racing, it's gonna be the exact same thing. So not too many apps that actually work. Again, if you search for any benchmark apps, so like Antutu or anything else, nothing is compatible with this TV box. So everything I had to install from the browser, so nothing can be installed from the Play Store. I'm not gonna say nothing, because you can probably find one or two apps that will actually work, but most of the apps from the Play Store will not work onto this TV box. And that is a shame, because it is the same issue that we had on the TX5 Pro. The root checker app will verify if the box has proper root access from the factory. Yes, this box does have root access from the factory. For those of you that were wondering how fast the internal memory and RAM is, these are the results for this test. On the Antutu benchmark, we get a rather low score of 28,000. That's followed by a multi-core score of 1759 and a single-core score of 643 on the Geekbench 3. And lastly, on the iStorm Extreme, the box gets a score of 4165, and down here we can see some more information about the test. The CPU-Z app will just confirm everything that we already know about the box, so I'm just gonna scroll through the tabs on top there. Unfortunately, there is no data for the temperature for the processor. On the Speedtest app, through a wired connection, the box gets a download speed of about 92 and 12 for upload, and connected to the Wi-Fi on the 2.4 GHz network, the box gets 18 download and 11 upload. Not the best, however, much better than most of these TV boxes. The box comes pre-installed with Kodi 16. I'm gonna open Kodi for you. This is the first time I'm actually opening Kodi, just so you have an idea how fast it starts up. So let's go to videos here. First, we'll check out what add-ons come pre-installed. So quite a few add-ons pre-installed onto Kodi. However, you can actually install all of these by yourself, so you don't really need all these add-ons. But yeah, a lot of add-ons come pre-installed. Let's go to settings here for a bit. System info, and here we can check out some more information about the box, and I'm just gonna scroll through them. And since I'm here anyways, let's open a random stream from here. So let's go to add-ons. And let's try this one here, see if we can get something going. So I chose a random one just so we can see if it starts up. And yeah, it does seem to start up quite fast, and everything seems to go on okay. Now, since I have Kodi opened here, let me go back here. I have a USB stick plugged into the box, so we can check out a couple of files. So let's click on files. This is the USB stick. Now, this file here, the first one, I highly doubt it's gonna go okay. It doesn't seem to do good on any of these S905X boxes, and as I was expecting, no, it doesn't do good. So the box kind of freezes, nothing happens. So the exact same behavior that we see on most of these boxes. So unfortunately, I had to exit Kodi. I'll go back in. The next one, it's this one here, another 4K file. This one, I expect it's gonna do much better. So yeah, this one does really good. So only the first one had a couple of issues. This one seems to do very well. The following clip, so this one is another 4K file that I filmed with my phone. This one should do okay. Unfortunately, the box just froze. Nothing happens anymore. So I'll have to exit this again and try it again. Oh, wait. So it did start up. However, we just see a black screen. So we tried those on Kodi and unfortunately they don't seem to work. So I'm gonna try the same files on the MX Player. I did install MX Player onto this box. So let's go to apps here. So everything is done in like super slow motion. I don't even know what's happening anymore. So let's try that again. I'll open the MX Player. As you can probably tell, the box is quite slow. So we'll give it access. We'll select OK. Let's press refresh. So the USB stick is right here. Let's try that 4K file again. So the one filmed with my phone. Aside from this blue thing in the middle there and the fact that it doesn't go smooth at all, it does seem to work. So we'll go back. So yeah, the box moves very, very slow. I have to like click twice and nothing happens. Let's try this one right here. This one, it's a difficult file for most of these TV boxes, so I don't believe it's gonna go too good on this one. We'll skip forward a bit. Doesn't seem to do that bad, however it's not totally smooth as you can probably tell. However, it does better than other boxes. Let's try this one here as well. So it does seem to do very, very good. 720p and 1080p files, like regular files like these ones that I have here, will do just fine, no issues whatsoever. However, with the first 4K file, all of these S905X boxes have trouble playing it. So yeah, 720p and 1080p files will do just fine. I have Miracast open on the device and onto my phone, so I can easily move left, right, so whatever I'm doing onto the phone, it's gonna show up on the box. I'm just gonna open the gallery here very quickly, just see a couple of pictures, so just scrolling in between them. So they do seem to go okay, but this is gonna have to do a lot with your Wi-Fi speed. So basically, if the box doesn't have great Wi-Fi speed, this is gonna go even slower. So Miracast will work with this device. I have the YouTube app that comes pre-installed with the box opened. I'm gonna play one of my own videos. The maximum resolution is at 720p and I'm just gonna play it for a bit so we can see how smooth it goes, and it does seem to do quite all right. So YouTube on this box 720p, but the video seems to go very smooth. So in order to conclude, the box comes with this launcher that's not the greatest launcher out there. You can install other launchers, however you're not gonna find any from the Play Store because most of the apps from the Play Store don't seem to work. Most of them say that they're not compatible, so that is a shame, but most of the apps that you've seen onto the box at this particular time, I installed myself from the browser, so I downloaded them and installed them. So as you can see, there are no games or anything that show up here. So yeah, the Play Store, it's kind of useless for this box, just like on the TX5. That being said, aside from the fact that the Play Store doesn't work, we don't have the navigation bar at the bottom of the screen here, which I find very useful. However, we don't have it onto this box. Another thing that I don't like about the box is the fact that everything takes quite long to actually happen, so by the time you actually open apps and close them and switching between them, it takes a while, so the box is not the fastest out there. That same 4K file that doesn't work on most of these S905X boxes didn't work on this box either, so keep that in mind. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment down below. Hopefully you enjoyed this video and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.